What's up, everybody? Welcome to a new English bit. In today's video, we're going to learn 5 informal expressions. Are you ready? So take a notebook and let's kick off. So the expressions we're going to learn today are used both in the UK and the USA. And the first one is to follow somebody's lead, which means to follow somebody's action or to do the same thing as somebody else has done. En castellano sería seguir el ejemplo de alguien. And now let's look at 2 examples. The first one, Jake followed her lead and voted in favor of the proposal. And the second example, I know this area very well, so we won't get lost. Just follow my lead. Now let's move on to our second expression, which is I have to take off, or I need to take off, or I should take off. And in this case, the phrase verb to take off means to leave. This expression is very common, and en castellano sería me tengo que ir. And now let's look at 2 examples. The first one, it's getting late, I should take off. And the second example, sorry, I have to take off if I don't want to get late to the meeting. And now let's look at our expression number 3, which is nailed it. It means to do something perfectly or to say the correct thing. It comes from the idiom to hit the nail on the head. And it can be also used sarcastically. En castellano sería dar en el clavo. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, how was the exam? Nailed it. The second example, the cake is delicious. Nailed it. Or another example, you nailed your speech today. Now let's move on to our expression number 4, which is no hard feelings. We use this expression to tell somebody that we are not angry with them after an argument or disagreement, or to ask if somebody else is upset. En castellano sería sin rencor, todo olvidado o sin mal rollo. And now let's look at some examples. The first one, apology accepted, no hard feelings. And the second example, sorry for giving away your secret, no hard feelings. And last but not least, a very funny expression, chop chop. It means to hurry up, darse prisa. And now let's look at 2 examples. The first example, we are running out of time, chop chop. Or another example, let's go, chop chop. So I really hope you enjoyed this English bit. If you want to learn more informal expressions, you can check out the first edition right here. And please let me know in the comments below which expression is your favorite. In my case, it's chop chop. And of course, if you enjoyed this English bit, don't forget to like it, to subscribe to the channel just down there, and share this video with your friends. With that being said, thanks for watching and see you next week. Ciao!